taken up area now, part of Frankfurt International that all used to belong to US Air Force. We had thousands of troops stationed here at Frankfurt. We had the Army and the Air Force. That land was given back to the German government. Must be about 10 years ago now. And also coming up shortly on the right-hand side is a memorial for those who lost their lives during the so-called Berlin blockade or Berlin airlift. That was when the care packets were dropped over Berlin. So coming up on the right, you'll see two of the Douglas aircraft that we used, and it's a kind of concrete memorial. It looks like part of a bridge with a prong at the top. So that comes up on the right hand side. You can see people already there, standing there here. They were also known as the Raisin Bombers, because they used to drop sweets for the little ones. So here, see them all looking. So those were the part of the air missions. So what was the Berlin blockade, Berlin air mission? Well, this took place, started in June of 1948 and lasted almost a year. Now you have to imagine a Berlin, you've got the eastern side of Germany, and Berlin was like an island in the eastern part of Germany, and that was also separated out. The eastern part of Berlin was run by the Soviets and the western part by the other allies. And in June of 1948, coinciding with the introduction of the German D-Mark, the Soviets suddenly tried to go against and went really against all the jurisdictions that were put upon them after the end of the Second World War. So they tried to stop these jurisdictions and to force a change. They decided to stop off the waterway, the roadway and the trains going into West Berlin that used to carry all the wares and all the goods for the Berliners. So you can imagine there were 2 million people in West Berlin, and they only had food that was going to last them for 2 weeks. So they, you can imagine they were all absolutely terrified. When the Allies, they came up with a brilliant plan. They were going to fly the air missions, the Berlin blockade, and air crews from all the Allies, they flew the missions for almost a year, from June until 48 until May 1949, and dropped the so-called care packets, food and all the things you needed over West Berlin for the West Berliners. And as I say, many of them, well, as well, they used to have drop little parachutes that had candy on it for the children. That was, and the Berliners, very, very glad, still today, thankful to all the Allies for practically saving them. They would have effectively have starved. Come May of 1949, the Soviets realised that they were actually hurting themselves, because of course there were a lot of sanctions put on to any of the products that were exported from the Eastern Bloc. So the jurisdiction, that blockade was lifted, but unfortunately those air missions, some people did lose their lives, and in memory of those who lost their lives, there is a memorial here at Frankfurt, one in just outside Hanover in the cellar, and one in Berlin. Exactly the same, they have the Douglas aircraft, and then there's a, as I said, there's a kind of part of a bridge, and the prong at the top, the three corridors, the air corridors that were used by the Allies to drop the care packets and the sweets and chocolates for the little ones. to have been one of the first major crises of the Cold War. This stretch of road or freeway that we're on now, this is known as the Bergstrasse. Road, Roman legions marched down here on their way to Heidelberg. It wasn't known as Heidelberg then, but there was a very, very large Roman fortress on one of the hillsides. And this has been since Roman times a very important trading route. And that's why also, you know, I know you had a lot of Roman history when you were in Trier. Of the towns along this way, you still have Roman artifacts, evidence that the Romans were here can still be found. It's also a very, very fertile area, even more fertile when we get nearer to Heidelberg. You could call it the market garden of Germany, of one of the market gardens. We have a lot of fruit, a lot of vegetables grown here. Meeting time of I'll mark the restaurant where we'll have lunch and the meeting time for this afternoon 3:30. That's for those of you who don't go up to the castle. And then when I've given out the maps, we'll have a short little rundown so that everyone's sure of the options and the times.
Thank you.
we're just passing the city of Darmstadt. We sometimes drive through here if all the freeways are blocked. We'll go via the Darmstadt. Darmstadt is known as the city of science, a very wealthy city because of all the technological firms, all the institutes that have something to do with technology, also very prestigious technical university. And it's also, here is the seat of the oldest pharmaceutical company in the world, the firm of Merck. They've been around, they had their foundation in 1668. Now that was their headquarters here, and it's one of the largest employers. And it's one of the wealthiest cities in the country, one of the wealthiest in Europe, actually, although it's not on a river. Most of the very important cities. Ladies and gentlemen, and give out the maps, and then we'll have a little look at them together. What I also have with me, I'll be giving you out as well as some welcome cards for the specialist Christmas shop that there is in Heidelberg. You might pop in there, you might see something, so I'll give out that you like.
This is really
know of someone.
Okay.
You know, yeah. It's difficult. Just look at those mats that I've given out just for a couple of minutes, please. We get into Heidelberg, which should be around, if we don't experience any more traffic jams, should be around 10 past 11. We're making our way directly to the bus pick up and drop off. That's the Neckarmünzplatz. If you look on the right hand side of the map, just under